Power.
Jesus. Are you ready?
Your name will be seen.
May you reign forever. talk to me.
Nobody will tell you. God bless you. What's that? What's that?
Pictures where when she was in the hospital.
Okay, the pictures are when she was in the hospital.
Yes.
Look at that. She was in the hospital bed. Look at it. Jesus is the doctor of all doctors.
Yes.
Thank you very much, colleagues. Now, I want to ask you only one question. The husband. You said you never believed God before. You never believed even the miracles that we were doing here. Now, your wife is now back to life. Do you believe, or you never still believe, or we should do more? Answer me, doctor.
Thank you, prophet. I fully believe in your God, number one. In your miracles, in your anointing, and the grace God has given to you. As a matter of fact, I wanted to take my wife back to Lagos, but before God and man, I hereby declare that I have given her to you.
Oh, you want to carry your wife go back to Lagos before? Yes. Before the incident or what? Before the sickness or what?
Yeah, before the sickness.
You want to carry her back home?
Yes.
Yeah.
I wanted to take her back to Lagos. As it is now, I don't have choice. I've given it back to you, sir.
Hey, doctors, colleagues, how do you, I don't know, doctors, what do you have to say?
Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Indeed, we were overwhelmed. Now, like our prophet said, many doctors probably do not believe in miracles.
Yes.
Well, some do. I am a believer. And I think the day he called me and was crying and said he has lost his wife, I was in the call room that day. I had to rush out. And he had given up. You know, so I think that evening he called again. There was nothing I could tell him other than what he had already heard in worry. But somehow, I told him, your wife will not die. All right? I said that with faith because I'm a believer. I have seen miracles, but not this close as we've witnessed.
Okay.
So I tried to encourage him.
That was okay.
I tried to encourage him, but I think maybe because it doesn't seem like he didn't take it. He just had to accept it. I prayed with him on the phone. Then I was still in Lagos. He was in Port Harcourt and in Warri. Now, when he called me later, the tone of his voice had changed. This was somebody that was crying. He was sounding so excited. I was like, what is going on? I was like, if you see the experiment, that was the term he used, that was performed on my wife in church.
Experiment?
Yes.
Is that a miracle? It's an experiment.
No, I think he probably said that out of excitement.
Okay, excited, okay.
Yes, he didn't believe, it happened so fast.
So fast?
Yes, he could not explain. So, with the tone of his voice, I already knew there was something good. And he told me, the God of Mercy Land has done it. I didn't have any reason to doubt because I have witnessed some miracles. But whether we like it or not, sometimes you try to think, is this real? But the fact that this is my colleague's wife, this is a lady I saw the other time we came and did everything to make us comfortable. I could see the pictures he showed me. So this was not arranged. This was not
arranged.
This was not Nollywood. It wasn't anything. I went on my knees, and the only thing I could say was, Thank you, Jesus. Amen. So we have come to say, well, just like the woman with the issue of blood, The Bible might not have stated hospitals or things that were done, but we know that she had given up on the system, and the system probably had given up on her. But one thing she said, if I could touch the hem of his garment, I think that was a similar thing she exhibited when she told the husband, take me there. And I believe her faith, well, the husband's weak faith at the time, all right, I think her faith really helped, and you could see how she held on to the prophet to say, don't give up on me. Today we have come to say, indeed, even though we know we treat, God heals, we can never share our glory with God. Even when you treat and the patient is well, we can never share our glory with God. So we have come to say, thank you, Lord, for this great miracle you have done.
Jam your hands. Look at what God is doing. You don't know what you carry, but begin to know what you carry.
Voilà, chers téléspectateurs, vous êtes en direct de Merci TV. À l'instant même, nous venons de suivre le merveilleux témoignage de cette femme qui était presque mourante, dès que nous avons vu à la vidéo. En effet, elle fut affligée par un problème rénal. Chers téléspectateurs, les médecins l'ont même référé en Inde pour une transplantation rénale. Chers téléspectateurs, cette transplantation qui leur a coûté vraiment une somme de 6 à 10 millions de dinars. Alors, elle a dit que tout a commencé comme juste un malaise et s'est poursuivi par une fièvre typhoïde, chers téléspectateurs, et ceci l'a affecté énormément. Et dès que nous avons vu dans la vidéo, cette femme était presque mourante parce que même son mari qui est médecin n'a pas vraiment pu apporter vraiment de solution malgré tous les médicaments qui ont été prescrits, malgré tous ces traitements. Alors, chers téléspectateurs, il était vraiment désespéré, plaidant à l'homme de Dieu pour avoir une intervention divine. Et après la prière de l'homme de Dieu, cette femme s'est sentie très, très rétablie. Et après juste cette prière, chers téléspectateurs, aujourd'hui, elle n'est plus pâle, elle est en forme. Les symptômes qu'elle expérimentait par le passé ont disparu et sont allés pour un second test qui a effectivement confirmé la guérison de cette femme. Elle est totalement libérée de ce problème rénal. Et aujourd'hui, elle est là avec ses collègues médecins pour dire qu'effectivement, ils ont donné leur meilleur et ils ont fait de leur mieux, chers téléspectateurs, que les médecins également traitent, mais c'est le Seigneur seul qui guérit. Aujourd'hui, elle est totalement libérée pour la gloire de notre Seigneur Jésus-Christ à travers la vie de l'homme de Dieu, prophète Jérémie Moutofofé.
Lamazou. Applaudissez.
Applaudissez. Pour le Seigneur.
God is too good. And I thank God for your life, doctor and doctors, colleagues, and also the family, brothers and sisters here. Stand up, sister. How are you? How are you?
Fine, sir.
So, now you believe the God of a woman,
huh? I believe.
Whenever I bring water of life, you say, keep this thing aside. Whenever I want to use oil of mercy, say, leave this thing. It doesn't work. Just...
doesn't work.
Yes.
He did not talk that one.
I'll bring wristband. You say, what is this? It's women.
He said, what? The wristband, what?
He said, no, it's for women.
It's for women?
Yeah.
Not for men. But right now, he put on one.
Alors, bien avant, il croyait pas au miracle.
Mais are you a woman?
No.
You're a man. You can see, these are the things of God. Jesus said, without miracle, they will not believe in him. So these are the things, because the unbelievers, we have to believe, make them to believe. Are you hearing me? So may God bless you. Viewers all over the world, wherever you are watching, Mercy TV, through YouTube, Facebook, any social media, you are watching Mercy TV. These are the things that we have been telling you. Right now, it's happening right in Delta State, Nigeria. Worry. Anytime, any hour, you can see, and our informations are also there. You can now call our prayer lines, inquire from them that they will now tell you how to get to worry. They will direct you. Those who cannot come and who are watching me all over the world, there's no distance in prayer. That's why I always carry water and water to pray for you people. Look at what the water of life has done. May the Lord bless you.
Put your hands together for Jesus.
May the Lord bless you. 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 God bless you for this testimony. God bless you. God bless you.
De Dieu se réjouir avec eux.
Bless you. Bless you.
Cette guérison.
Bless you. Thank you. Let your testimony be permanent. You shall not die young. In Jesus' name. Jesus.
Prayer line. Are you feeling lost or distressed? We give you a source of hope. Join the prayer line or our helpline and get the healing touch coupled with deliverance. Prayer line is a healing section where people with various ailments, afflictions, and infirmities are arranged with their placards ready to be touched with the healing power of God, armed with doctors or medical reports as proof. The placards explain or describe the type of ailment. They are prayed on or prayed for and asked to connect or be in tune before the commencement of the healing touch. Prayer is the turning of the human soul to the living God by just a word. Psalms 107 verse 20 declares, "He sent his word and healed them and delivered them from their destructions." New King James Version. Our prayer line are just a dial away 24/7.
Jesus, the Godfather of all Godfathers. Jesus, our great physician. There is no sickness he cannot heal. Every captive swims set free. Jesus, the Godfather.